Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act. The Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act 2019 that seeks to mainstream the transgender community has got presidential assent. The act seeks to define what is the meaning of the transgender, recognize the transgender persons, any discrimination against the transgender persons in the matters of education, health, employment, etc., protect the interest of the transgender community by setting up National Council for Transgender Persons. Definition of the transgender person. According to the Act, transgender person is the one who does not match with the gender assigned at the birth. The transgender person is the one who is neither wholly female or male, a combination of female or male, and neither female nor male. It also includes trans men, trans women, persons with intersex variations, gender peers, and also other social cultural identities like Kinnar, Hijra, Aravani, and Jogta. Recognition to the transgender persons. A person who have the right to choose to be identified as a man, woman, or transgender. For this, a transgender person may make any application to the district magistrate for the certificate of identity indicating the gender as transgender. The district magistrate will issue the certificate of identity based on the recommendations of the district screening committee comprising of chief medical officer, district social welfare officer, and the psychologist and psychiatrist representative of the such community. Besides, if an individual undergoes sex reassignment surgery, a revised certificate to be certified as transgender may be obtained. Prohibition against discrimination. The Act prohibits the discrimination against the transgender persons, including the denial of service or unfair treatment in relation to education, employment, healthcare, and right to reside. In employment, every establishment is required to designate a person to be compliant officer for grievance redressal. In healthcare services, the government must take steps to provide healthcare service facilities to such persons, including separate HIV surveillance centers, sex reassignment surgeries, hormonal therapy, etc., and provide comprehensive medical insurance coverage for the same. Right to residence. Every such person shall have a right to reside and be included in his household. If an immediate family is unable to take care of such person, the person may be placed in a rehabilitation center. Offences and penalties. The Act recognizes a number of offences for which the punishment may include imprisonment from 6 months to 2 years, or fine. The offences which attract punishment include forcing such person to leave the house, beg, or forced to bonded labour, denial of access to public places, physical, sexual, verbal, emotional, and economic abuse. National Council for Transgender. The Act also provides for constitution of the National Council for Transgender to advise the central government on the policy matters related to transgender persons. The National Council for Transgender shall consist of Union Minister of Social Justice as chairperson, Minister of State of Social Justice as vice chairperson, Secretary of the Ministry of Social Justice, one representative from the ministries including the Health, Home Affairs, Minority Affairs, Housing, Human Resources Development, etc. The representatives of Niti Aayog, National Human Rights Commission, and are also members. Commission for Women, representative from state governments, 5 members from the transgender community, and 5 experts from the NGOs. A critique, the issue of self-identification. While the Act rightly defines what are transgender as a person whose gender does not match with the gender assigned at the birth, it requires a district screening committee to certify the transgender. This makes the Act fundamentally flawed as it does not recognize the right to self-determination of the gender. This is against the spirit of the famous Nalsa decision of the Supreme Court of India in 2014, according to which a gender is an innate experience of an individual. Flawed definition. The Act includes under its definition of transgender, trans men and trans women, gender queers, persons with intersex variations. However, this definition is flawed because not every intersex person identifies as transgender, and not every transgender person is an intersex. The protection instead of promotion. While the Act provides for a legal penalties for violation of the transgender rights, in order to mainstream, what is needed is a promotion of the interest of the community. What is needed is promotion, but it is a protection oriented. The reservation of jobs and in educational institutions should be extended in that direction. Legal mainstreaming. Legal mainstreaming is a precursor to the social mainstreaming. Currently, several laws in India do not have an adequate provisions for the transgender. For instance, Section 376 of IPC dealing with the rape cases have provision only for women and not for transgender. Other issues. The Act provides for penalty against the people who compel or entice transgender into begging. This could prove to be detrimental to few transgender persons, especially hijras who, in the absence of other sources of livelihood, resort to begging. The punishment provided for in the Act is said to be too little, 2 years, in comparison to those for violence against a woman, minimum 7 years.